Hey everybody, Dominic here, and in this video I want to share with you one of the collaborative activities that I've developed using Google G Suite, and that is the collaborative wiki, which is not all that different from any other wiki page that you might interact with. For those of you who don't know, a wiki page is essentially an online web page in which different people are able to contribute and add and edit the content of the page. And the most popular example is Wikipedia, where different users can go in and add content. And the general idea is that over time, you create this wealth of knowledge by everyone contributing their ideas. Now, you can achieve the same thing in a classroom, and especially in an online classroom. This is where this type of activity can really shine. And leveraging a product like Google Docs is one way that you could achieve this because of how easy it is to collaborate in Google Docs. Now, I'm going to demonstrate for you a template that I've put together in Google Docs and talk a little bit about how I would utilize this template. So let me switch over here to this tab and show you this template that I put together. So what we have here is a Google Doc, and the kind of the general idea that I had when I was making this template was this might be used in one of our nursing courses. And you can see here that the first page of this document has a table of contents. In case you're not already aware, this is a feature that's in Google Docs. If you go up to Insert and you go down to the bottom, you'll see Table of Contents, and you can actually insert a table of contents that'll auto-populate itself based on the headers that you have selected within the document. So that's what I've done here. I've created this table of contents, and you can see it's auto-populated with all of these different headers. Okay. So that's the first page. Up here at the top, you would put in the course name. You could put some other information in here as well if you wanted to. Let's go down to page two. So on page two, you'll see that first of all, I've got this link back to top. I actually put this link in the header and in the footer of the pages. So on every single page is this back to top link. And you could always click on that link and get right back to the table of contents, which is kind of nice. If you're going through the pages and you want to get back to the table of contents, it's just a click away. Now what we see here is we have the unit one header. And then within this is a term, a vocabulary term that's relevant to the topic. Okay, in this case, direct care worker is the term. Now, the way that I've structured this, and actually let me go down to a blank template page. So you can see here on the blank one, we've got a term. So this is where you will type in the terminology that students need to learn. You'll see that this paste image here space, and this is where, oh, my dog is very upset. Kun, come here. It's okay. Paste image here. One of the activities that you would likely want to have your students do is to go find an image online that represents the term. This is similar to the activity that I've talked about in the past with the Google Slide Gallery Walk. I kind of do the same activity there of students go find a visual that represents the term. Then there's a space to provide a definition. If I were doing a learning activity with my students where I was using this wiki, I would have the students not just copy and paste a definition from their text or from the internet. I would tell them, I want you to put it in your own words. Okay, so they have to try to encourage them to think about it a little bit and put it in layman's terms. Okay. Then I have this application space, and the idea of the application space is to provide a little bit more description in regards to the terminology, or to apply it to a certain scenario, or to give some of your own personal background knowledge about it. Really what you're doing with application, it depends on what the learning objectives are for the course, but essentially, we're taking it beyond definition to actually apply that terminology in some way. And then the last part is questions. And essentially, the idea of this is that students can post any questions that they may have about the terminology. Their peers could go in and potentially answer those questions. Okay, so that's the general layout of these pages. Okay, so if I go back up to the example, we can see here, generally what I would do as the instructor is I would go through and I would provide the term. Okay, so I would put in direct care worker and I would fill all the other pages up with other terms. And then I would tell students, okay, I'm gonna put you into groups. Each group is gonna be assigned a term or a group of terms. In your group, one person needs to go find an image, one person needs to provide the definition, and then the last person needs to apply it and maybe alternate those responsibilities. Okay, so here we have an image that someone's provided of direct care worker. Here is a definition that a student has provided of what a direct care worker is. And then the last student has provided some more context as to what direct care workers are involved with. Okay. Now, what's great about this is that essentially by creating a collaborative wiki like this, it's essentially taking what would have been a student's individual study guide and distributing that work across the entire class. The whole class as a whole, they are coming together to create this wiki. And this wiki is going to be their reference document as they go through the course and they prepare for their summative assessments. So this is the type of activity that's actually going to likely follow students throughout an entire course. So that, you know, day one of the course, it's mostly empty, but by the last day of class, this is going to be full of pictures and definitions and ideas and context and questions. And I think the question part is really important because as the course progresses throughout the semester, at any point in time, students may come in here, they'll look up one of the terms and they have some questions about it. They're unsure, like, okay, would a direct care worker be the person responsible in this type of scenario? I'm not sure. And so they go in here, they put a bullet point in and they provide their question, okay? And then what you could encourage students to do is say, you know, week to week, I want you to go through this unit as well as previous units and look for any questions that anyone has posted. And if you can provide them with some solid feedback that answers their question, maybe I'll give you some extra credit points or something like that. The way in which you incentivize it, you'd want to think through a little bit for your learning context, what would be most appropriate. But a lot of benefit because think of all the information that is all going to be in one central location. That's a big benefit of doing this type of activity. There is so much content that's all going to be in one place. Now, as far as sharing this document goes, I would recommend, so if I go up here to share, right now, this is set, so this is in a team drive, so I have to click on who has access to look at the link. Right now it's set so that anyone with the link can view the document. That's because this is my template that I want to share with everybody. If I was doing this as an activity in my class, what I would recommend, first of all, I will turn off external access because I want them to be at CVTC if they're going to edit this document. And I'll switch it from can view to can edit. Okay, so anyone at CVTC with the link can edit. Okay, I would copy that link and then I would put it out in my Canvas course. And I would likely actually repeat that link from week to week, potentially, if this is going to be an activity that we're going to do over a long period of time. I'm going to switch this back because it's my template that I want to share with people. One thing to be cautious of. When you are making a collaborative assignment, like this one, there is always the potential that something might get deleted. Now, generally, hopefully those types of things are rare, and if they do happen, hopefully they happen on accident. but it is a possibility. The one thing I will remind you of, though, is that with something like a Google Doc, we can always go back to a previous version. So in this case, if someone had accidentally deleted something, I can just click up here in this link where it says last edited, and then I could see what this document looked like at different moments in time. And it will highlight who did what. So we can see here the green is me and it color codes that. If you have a large group of students, I might consider breaking this up and having each group do their own separate wiki. The reason I say that is if you have 20 students all working on the same wiki, you're going to have 20 names over here on the right-hand side with different colors, and it becomes really hard to see who's doing what. So in those types of scenarios where you do want to check and see who's doing what, you might want to break it up into group activities rather than a whole class activity. Really depends. You have to think about your learning context and decide what is the most appropriate scenario. You can also encourage your students to sign their name after they make a contribution. So if I was in this group and I did the definition, there's my definition, and then I'll just sign it Dominic. And that just makes it a little easier to see who's doing what. But this type of activity, again, I think there's a lot of benefit because number one, everything's in one place. Number two, students are generating their own study guide. And number three, they are able to build off of each other's ideas and they can easily reference this document when it comes time to prepare for a summative assessment. So I hope this looks like an intriguing activity to you. If you have questions about utilizing collaborative documents like this or creating a wiki for your class, definitely reach out to me. I'd be happy to help you out. So, thank you for watching.